Hello everyone! Again, I'm going to make geodecoasters, but this time I'm only going to use two colors. I'm going to add some glitter lines and some nice abalone shells. So for the new people to my channel that like tutorials of resin in this case, but I also have tutorials of acrylics, mixed media, alcohol ink and a lot more other tutorials, consider to subscribe. Click the notification bell and select all, because that way you don't miss any future videos that I will be uploading to my channel. So what I already mentioned, I'm going to make some nice geodecoasters, but this time a little bit different. I already started with adding the glitter lines. I'm using a blue glitter pen, and it's from the brand FIFA Decor. I get a lot of questions about this glitter pen. And I also added some nice abalone shells in my silicone mold. And now I'm making the lines. I'm drawing the lines around the abalone shells. And this is a very nice glitter pen, because you can make some nice lines with it. You need to let this dry for at least 24 hours before you can add the resin on top of it. But I think this is a nice way of adding some glitter details to your resin coasters. And I'm using the silicone mold from Molds and Shapes. They have amazing quality silicone molds, and I also have a promo code for their new website. My promo code is JustPaint5, and if you use my code, then you get 5% discount on your total value order, so that's great. All the information to my promo code is in the description box below this video. And I really like those abalone shells. They have such nice, pretty colors. And I'm thinking about selling these abalone shells in my Etsy shop. Because you can use them in resin art, but also you can glue them on your acrylic painting. Or you can use them for nail art, because they are very thin. And I'm thinking about selling these in my Etsy shop. So I'm almost done with the glitter lines. Then I need to let this dry for at least 24 hours before I can work on it again. So we are 24 hours later, and now I can pour the resin on top of the glitter lines. And I'm only going to use two colors, what I already mentioned in the beginning of this video. I'm going to use black, you see me pour it now, and I'm going to use turquoise, a transparent turquoise. And I'm starting with the black. This is the black paste from Resin Pro. And this silicone mold is 1 centimeter deep, so I need to pour up to 1 centimeter. Now I'm starting with the transparent turquoise, and I'm using a Bombay ink, and I also mixed in some of my own natural mica pigments. It's the Dazzle Gold. That color is not listed yet in my Etsy shop, but it will in a few weeks. This color will be listed. It's the same sparkle as the Sparkle White, but then in the golden color, so that's great. And I need to be careful with pouring these two colors, because I want to have a, not to let those colors blend into each other, because then the transparent effect will be gone, because the transparent color be on top of the abalone shells. Now I'm lifting the abalone shells, because otherwise you have air bubbles underneath the shells. And that's not what I want. So that's why I'm lifting them and placing them back into the resin. Okay, you can see it. Yeah, this is an experiment. Normally I make other geode coasters, but this time I thought, why not try this? And I'm using the Art Pro resin from a Resin Pro. I think it's an amazing resin because you can make paintings with it, but you can also pour into silicon molds with the same resin, because you can pour up to 1 centimeter, so that's great for this mold because the depth is 1 centimeter. And I must say there are not a lot of air bubbles in it, so that's also good. It's heat resistant up to 90 degrees. And I don't think that's enough, so that's why I'm adding a heat resistant layer. You will also see that in this video. And that layer is heat resistant up to 200 degrees, so that's great. Yeah, sometimes I add a heat resistant layer in the mold, that you will see in this video, but sometimes I will add it when the coasters are already out of the mold. Then I tape the backside. And I will add a heat resistant layer, but this time I will add it in the mold. So I will leave some room, room to add the layer. Now bit by bit I'm adding the two colors. So I'm not going to pour the colors on top of each other, so next to each other, and hopefully they don't blend too much or bleed in too much into each other. Because I want to have those colors separate from each other. So that you will see the shells in the transparent part of the coasters. The colors are almost touching each other. There you can see it. I'm using a heat gun to remove some air bubbles. I never use a torch when I pour into silicon molds, because the flame of the torch is very hot, and then you have a risk that your resin will stick to the silicon mold, and that's not good, because then you will damage your silicon mold when you take out your geode coasters. So if you are interested in one of the coaster molds, they have a lot of molds and shapes. The link to their new website is in the description box below this video. And what I already mentioned, the quality of their silicon molds is amazing. Don't forget my promo code. So bit by bit I'm adding the two colors. And I'm pouring right next to the edge, there you can see it. And that will, push the transparent part a little bit back. And the same I will do with the turquoise color. So in this video I will show you the whole process. Of course, what you see now, pouring into the silicon mold, but also taking it out, unmolding it, and of course the end result. And I will also be adding some mica flakes. I also sell mica flakes in my Etsy shop, and I will be using the Old Gold, and that's a flake with a size of 3 to 5 millimeters. So And I think it will look nice if I add some of those mica flakes. So if you are interested in my natural mica pigments or mica flakes, I have listed them in my Etsy shop. The link to my Etsy shop is in the description box below this video. And they are also available in the USA and Canada by my associate Evelyn Schaefer. And we are working on getting new colors listed in our Etsy shop. And it's a lot of work to take the photos, because you want to have nice photos and videos. And but there will be more colors listed in a few weeks. So the links to our Etsy shops is below this video in the description box. So if you are interested or curious, then you can check out our Etsy shops. Still adding the turquoise color. And so you can see I'm using a lot of times my heat gun to remove small air bubbles, because it's not nice if you have air bubbles in your coaster. There you can see it adding a little bit more of the black paste. No, it's not a paste. Yeah, it's a paste, the black color, when you mix it into your resin. Again, the heat gun. And hopefully those two colors will stay separate, that they don't blend too much into each other. Because I want to have the effect of a transparent part and a part that is not see-through. Yeah, I still need to add more resin because I'm not all the way to the top of the coaster mold. Yeah, I need to leave room for the heat-resistant layer. So all the materials I'm using in this video, you can find at the end of the video, but also in the description box below this video. And I always add the links to the website, so if you're curious where I buy my materials, then you can check out the description box. So there you can see me add some nice mica flakes that I sell in my Etsy shop. And this is the color Old Gold. And I'm only adding a few, not a lot. But I think it will look nice if I add them together with the abalone shells and the glitter line. And I push those mica flakes all the way under the resin, so that they are below the resin. So no, not floating on top of it. So I will also add the links to the glitter pen in the description box below this video, because I got a lot of questions which brand it was and where to buy it. So I will add a link in the description box. So a few more flakes and then I'm almost done. Then I need to let this dry before I can add a heat resistant layer. I'm so sorry for my friend's bulldog. So the resin is dry. I can add the heat resistant layer. There you can see it. So I normally add the layer when they are out of the mold. But you can also add this layer when the coasters are still in the mold. Maybe that's easier. Because when they are out of the mold, then you need to tape the other sides so that you can remove the drips much easier. What I also did is that I sanded the surface, the resin surface, with sandpaper, 400 grit. And now I'm adding the heat resistant layer. And I'm using the Top Pro resin from Resin Pro. That link you can also find in the description box below this video. And you don't need a lot for this heat resistant layer. And the other side will also get a heat resistant layer, but yeah. Then they need to be out of the mold. So that these coasters can be used on both sides. Because that's my goal. And they dried very well, the coasters. And this side is really nice. Also, the microflakes and the abalone shells look very pretty. But I'm very curious how the other side looks of the coasters. Making sure I have it all covered with a heat resistant resin. So we are 24 hours later and now I can take the coasters out of the mold. I'm very curious how the other side looks. And normally I don't have any problems with taking the coasters out of the silicone mold because I don't use a torch. And yeah, it goes very easy. This side already looks amazing. So hopefully the other side will also look nice. Then they can be used on both sides. But what I really like is that the colors still are separate. So they didn't blend too much together. There you can see it. You have a transparent part and a part that is not see-through. So that was my goal. Now we can take a closer look. The glitter lines look amazing. There you can see it. At the end of the video, I'll show you all a close-up, then you can see the sparkle much better, but also the abalone shells and the glitter lines, the mica flakes, and the dazzle gold that I mixed into the turquoise color. It sparkles a lot. Yeah, that's also very nice with the glitter lines. You can see the shells very good. They have such pretty colors. Yeah, I'm very pleased how these coasters look. So I will add a heat resistant layer also on this side that you see now. Because then they can be used on both sides. But so far I'm very pleased. There you can see it, the nice glitter lines, the mica flakes. You can already see some of the sparkle of the dazzle gold. There you can see it. Yeah. Really nice. Then I'm trying to show you the glitter lines. There you can see it much better. A little bit closer. Yeah, very difficult to film this. This is the end result. I have added a heat resistant layer also on the other side. I didn't show you that. And I've added the gilding edge, gilding liquid on the edge, and I've used the Resin Pro gilding liquid in the color gold. And you can add it with a brush. I will also put a link of the gilding liquid in the description box below this video. But I'm very pleased how these coasters turned out. Very nice, the abalone shells and the mica flakes. You can already see the sparkle of the Dazzle Gold. And the nice glitter lines, those glitter pens work amazing. If you want to have really fine, thin glitter lines, then these pens are really good for that. So if you like what I'm doing, consider to subscribe. Don't forget to give me a thumbs up. All the supplies of use you can find in the description box. Also the link to my Facebook group if you want to join me. The link to it is in the description box. I want to thank you all for watching again. And hopefully I will see you in the next video. Bye.